Firefighters in our city had a unique kind of training today. Fox 5's Kirika Azuka gives us a look at their practice at the high roller.
Eyes were to the sky as onlookers watched the type of training that you don't see every day. Firefighters propelling themselves from the high roller.
The high roller is approximately 550 feet off the ground at the very top, and so they could have to rescue somebody anywhere in there.
Thomas Touchstone is the deputy chief with the Clark County Fire Department, and he says these skills can be used to rescue people if the attraction were to malfunction, but they can also come in handy in other ways.
It's very similar in nature to like rescuing a window washer or a construction worker who has taken a fall.
Touchstone says the training is a good way for first responders to practice motor skills, learn to trust their peers, and most importantly, build confidence.
When they get to the victim, they have to show that confidence and build confidence in the victim that, you know, they're not going to drop them, that they're going to safely get them to the ground.
So what are the firefighters thinking as they're suspended hundreds of feet above the ground?
There's going to be some anxiety. I wouldn't call it fear necessarily. It's probably more adrenaline than anything else. You know, it's really what they live for.
Like anything else, you get a little anxious as you go out there.
Captain Rafael Espinoza with City of Las Vegas Fire and Rescue has been a part of this exercise since before the high roller even opened.
When we go out there, it's really a lot of muscle memory of just going and trusting our equipment and our training and go out there and get the job done.
And they say the hard work is worth it.
But the important thing for our tourist residents and visitors to understand is that if there was a mechanical failure, we're here, we're training, and we're prepared.
We as a department and as a technical rescue team always just want to get better. We have a lot of younger and newer firefighters with us, and that's the motivation, right? To kind of keep training, keep people going, to know that whether we're here or not here, that we can get these rescues done if we're ever in that position, and that everyone is comfortable doing their job.